Welcome students, myself Uparaja Rahul, and today we are going to learn about the mathematics of class 9th. Okay, so today's is standard 9th maths. Okay, today we are going to learn about the mathematics of class 9th. Okay, so as per the standard 9th class maths, okay. We have to learn previous lectures about the graphical representation of the linear equation in one variable and linear equation in two variable. Okay, for that we have to learn how to represent them using coordinate geometry. Okay, and we are representing them as the using Cartesian plane and as the straight line. Okay, then we are representing them linear equation in one variable as only number line, and we have to represent them linear equation in two variable only and only as the straight line. Okay, so now today we have to learn about the new topic of the standard 9th, that is my chapter number 14, that is about the statistics. Okay, so today we have to start the new topic, that is statistic. Okay, so in the statistic we have to learn about the data. Okay, today we have to learn about the data. So what is the data? First of all, what is the data? Okay, so as per the question, we have to write it here that data means collection of the well-defined information. Okay, we have to learn about the collection of the well-defined information. So that is my collection of well-defined information. Okay, so here in between the difference between the data and information, there are the lots of the difference between data and information. So what is the difference between information and data? Information, and I'll give you some example of depend on the data and depend on the information. So one thing, I'm in the school and I'm the principal of the school. So I tell to all students that make all of our cat in the one gram, all over in the gram. So my standard 1, standard 2, standard 3, all of the students of the all of the standard are collected in a gram. Okay, all of the students are comes in the gram, and just tell them that collect or comes in the gram. Okay, so when all of the students are comes in the gram, okay, so there is not any kind of the defined that any kind of the students are arranged. There is not any kind of the students are arranged in well defined, like in a row or in a column or in a number wise or in class wise or as a name wise. Okay, there is not kind of any instruction or information given them that arrange any kind of the situation. But when I talk about the data, then in data, what I tell to the students that comes in the gram or to all students, I am telling to all students to comes in the gram and arrange or stand along with the and stand along with class wise. Okay. So I am telling here about the student. I am telling here to the student that all of the students can face can do the ground and all of the students are arranged or stand out as a class wise. Okay. So now in the information, whenever I talk to the standard 9, whenever I talk to the students to the 9, okay, so that information are says as to the all of the students. Okay, but when I talk to this data, when I talk to data and say to the standard 9, then particular row or column of the standard 9 are raise their hand. Okay, so there is a differentiate between the information and data. I will give you one example about the information and data, that is one of the simple example of the information, that is name of all students, that is name of all students, just name of all students of the school. Okay, here your data, your information is like name of all students of the school. Okay, there is generally name that are not arranged in any kind of the roll number wise or any kind of the alphabetical wise or ascending or descending or class wise or standard wise. Okay, but in the data we have to tell about the name of the students, name of students, that is class wise or name wise or age wise, okay, etc. You have to arrange name of the all students of this all students, name of the all students of school. You have to arrange name of the all students of the school as a class wise or name wise or age wise or etc. any kind of them. Then you have to define the data of the information. There is generally information, that is name of the students of the all of the school. Okay. Then here I will define that name of all of students of the all school as a class wise or name wise or age wise. Okay. So in the data, I am arranging the data in the standard formation, that is as ascending or descending or any particular row wise, any particular row wise or any particular column wise or any kind of the particular definite situation. Okay, so there is a differentiation between the data and information. Okay, now we are moving on the type of the data. That is the type of the data. There is a two type of the data, that is group data or non-group data. Okay, types of data, there is a two types of data, that is group data and there is second one is ungroup data. Okay, first one is group data and second one is ungroup data. Okay, group data you have to learn in this standard 10. Okay, and now we have to learn about the ungroup data in standard 9, and we have to also learn about the how to convert ungroup data to data. Okay. And the standard 9, and we have learned about the intersection, that is we have to convert group data into the okay. So let's start about the first of all ungrouped data. So ungrouped data, we call them also as a row data. Okay. Next, second name of the ungrouped data is the row data. Now I'll find some of the numbers, that is 2, 5, 8, 10, 12, 6, 3, 9, 2, 4, 8, 3, 6, 18, 20, 22, 24, 16, 12, 18, 13, 14, 16, 12, 10, and 8. Okay. Here is my some kind of the data are available. That is my marks of the students from the 25. That is my data is marks of students out of 25. Okay. Out of 25, there is a marks of the students. Okay. Now I want to try to solve this kind of the data. Now how to solve this kind of the data? First of all of this kind of the data we have to say them as ungrouped data. Okay, we send them ungrouped data. Okay, because of the data are written as a row, because of the data written in the row, that's why we call it as a row data. Okay. Now, particular values of the data are also called as observation of data. That's it. That's my observation of the data. That's my observation of the data. Okay. Particular value, everyone value, that we call them as a observation of the data. Okay. Now we moving on the some define. That is first of all that is as a range. Now we are moving on the particular define, that is range. What is my range? Range means that is highest value minus lowest value. Okay. Highest value of or highest observation, you have to write as observation. Highest observation minus lowest observation is known as the range of the data. Okay. Now in the data, what is the highest observation? My highest observation is 24. Therefore, 24 minus lowest observation, that is my 2. Lowest observation, that is my 2. Therefore, my range of the data is 22. Okay. Therefore, my range of data is 22. Clear, students? Okay. Now, we also call ungrouped data as a primary data. Also, there is a second name is primary data. Okay. This data is also known as the primary data. Whenever we convert in the group data, whenever we convert primary data into the group data, we call them as a secondary data. We call them as secondary data. Okay. Okay, students. Now we have to move to convert this data or use this data to convert in the column wise, and we have to see that how many times of the observation, each observation are repeated in how many times. Okay, now we have to solve them. When we solve them, we have to convert row data into the column wise. Okay, so here my observations, we have to use tally marks to count that how many times of the particular observation are repeated. Okay, so my observation, they have to generally contain only one observation, that is my 2, 5, that is 8. After 8, any kind of value are here. First of all, I have got this, and after 2, any kind of the value are appear here, that is yes, that is 3. After that, 4, yes, 4 also available. 5 is available, yes, 5 also available. 6 also available. 7 is available, no, there is not 7, there is a 8. After 10, after 12, after that at 13, no, 14 not, 14 yes, 14 available. After that 15 is here, you know, 15 no, 16, 16 is available. After 18 is also available, there is 20, 22 and 24. Okay, yes, here 13 is available, that is my 13, here is a 13, so I will write here 13 also. Okay, now we have to put these values.
So I'll write the values
frequency. Okay, frequency. Okay. So for 2, my frequency is 2. For 3, that's 2. 4 is 1. 5 is 1. 6 is 2. 8 is 3. 10 is 2. 12 is 3. 13 is 1. 14 is 1. 16 is 2. 18 is 2. 20 is 1. 22 is also 1. And 24 is also 1. And 9 is also 1. So here, we have to conclude that my observation, that is number is a 2, that is repeated on the in the data, that is 2 times my observation 2 is repeated 2 times, my observation 3, that is repeated also 2 times, observation 4 is written as 1, observation 5 also written as 1, observation 6 is written as 2 times, observation 8, that is repeated 3 times, observation 8, that is appear here 3 times, observation 10, that is repeated or appear here is 2 times, observation 12, that is appear here is 3 times, and so on. So what is my frequency? I write here the frequency fi, then what is the define of the frequency? That is frequency means how many times of the observation are repeated, that is known as the frequency. My demand of the frequency, that is number of repeated number of observation are repeated number of times that are observation are repeated, that is my frequency. Number of times repeated observation is known as frequency. Okay. Number of times repeated observation, that is my frequency. Then how many times observation are repeated, that is my observation known as the frequency. Okay. So students, clear all things. Okay. Now we have to write another type of the data, and we have to solve them using the tally marks. This is my raw data, and I converted this as into the tabular form in using the frequency. Therefore, I am telling this table as my frequency distribution table. Okay. So as what I tell this table, what I am telling there, that this table, that is I am telling the frequency distribution table. Okay. This is my frequency distribution table. Here is my question, that there is a 40 families, okay, here is my 40 families, following it up is the number of children in the 40 families, and represent it in the form of the frequency distribution. Okay, represent it in the frequency distribution. Okay, that is my data is 1, 2, 6, 5, 1, 5, 1, 3, 2, 6, 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 3, 4, 2, 0, 0, that is 4 4 3 2 2 0 0 1 2 2 4 3 2 1 0 5 1 2 4 3 4 1 6 2 2 okay here my data is given as a number of the children are in 40 categories okay this my data is the number of the children in 40 families okay now I have to convert this data into the frequency distribution table. So how to convert this data into frequency distribution table? First of all, I put the number of children at here. After that, I have tally marks, and last one is my frequency. Okay. So what is my lowest value? That is my lowest value, that is 0. After that 1, 2, 3, 4, and last one is 5 and 6. Okay. Clear? Using the first of all, so 1 that is I put as 1, 2, 6 in this is 1, 5 repeated as first time that is 4, 1, 1 is second time therefore I put as 2 means second tally mark on the 1, now 5 that is again in the 5, again 2, again 1 sorry. 3, 2, 6, sorry, after that another time 2, 3, 4, sorry, 4, 2, 0, another time 0, after that 4, 4, 4, 4, 3, 2, now I will update 2 on the data, here is my 4 times of the tally marks are available, so now 2 is repeated 5th time, so if whenever any kind of the observation are repeated 5th time, then you have to consider and write as the as here. That is my group of the 5 frequencies. Okay. Another time 2, that is I'll add as again at 1 0 0 1 2 2 4. Now 4 is repeated 5th time, therefore I will represent that is group of the 5 as here, like this. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, that is group of 5, 0 is also now group of the 5, 5, 1, 2, now also group of the 5, 4, 3, 4, 1, 6, 2, and 2. Okay. Now I write the frequency. Now 0 is repeated how many times? That is 5 times. Okay. Now one is you get 5, that is 5 and 2 extra, that is 5 plus 2, that is my 7. Okay. Now 2 is repeated 5 12 times. 3 is repeated 4 times. 4 is repeated 5 plus 2 7 times. 5 is repeated 3 times. And 6 is repeated also 3 times. Okay. This is my frequency distribution table. This is my frequency distribution table. Okay. This is my frequency distribution table. Clear, students? Okay. So today we have to learn that this data, how to convert data into the frequency distribution table. Okay. We have to learn about the how this data, what is range, what is observation. Okay. And what is frequency and what is raw data, converted raw data into the frequency distribution table. Okay. So students, I hope you have to clear all things in the today's lesson. Okay. So till then, goodbye and stay blessed.